Welcome to Greyhound Football. It's the Newport Greyhounds, and we're on the road at Nettleton to start the 2015 season. And no better person to talk to as we start out the year than John Bradley, who has come home to be the offensive coordinator for the Newport Greyhounds. John, welcome home.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Hey, talk a little bit about you being back home. Talk a little bit about being a Greyhound again.
It's a great opportunity for me to come home. You know, I've been a head coach for the last 10 years and got this opportunity to come back, and I've known Coach Hinesley for a long time. And just having an opportunity to come back and be around my family again and be in a town that supports football as much as Newport does, it's a great experience, great place for me to raise my kids.
If you weren't at the junior high football game last night, the Hound defense makes a stand late, and they drive it 90-plus yards for the winning touchdown. In an offense that is your offense, that's designed by you, talk just a little bit generally about our offense.
You know, it's a run-oriented offense, but we do a lot of things out of a spread look. We're always going to have a receiver, you know, possibly two. But we're making it where it's very difficult to key on one person. In the past, we've looked at some tendencies that Newport's had with people keying on Carl, and we're trying to take those tendencies away, and have got four guys in the backfield that can run the ball at any time. And all of them are very fast and really good with the ball in their hands. So we want to make sure that we give those guys an opportunity to do something with it. And that, you know, we're, like I said, we're kind of a clock control, but we can go fast if we need to. We had a plan the other night in the scrimmage game to try to slow it down a little bit. And, you know, we scored twice in the first three plays. So, but we'll take those. We'll take them.
Absolutely. Well, Coach Lesson, I'm glad you're here. Ought to be an outstanding season. We got a brutal schedule. It always is. This is a big test for our football team tonight.
Yeah, Nettleton's a good football team. And, you know, I think they're ranked 11th in 5A and finished the year on a high note last year, playing really well at the end. And they've got a lot of kids. They don't play very many both ways, and they're big. It's going to be a big physical team. It's definitely going to be a test for us.
Looking forward to it, my friend. I know you got to go to work. Good to see you, John Bradley.
Thank you very much.
Hey, we're going to take it upstairs. David Black, Randy Klopeska, we're next. Joined by my tag team partner, Randy Klopeska, in the booth again. And last year, at the end of the year, we thought it was retirement all the way, but with my great encouraging words to Randy C, he's back for most of the season. I'm glad to have you back, my friend.
Thanks. Good to be back, David. Yeah, a little encouraging, arm twisting, whatever you want to say. I'm going to be back for, we'll say, one more year now. Who knows? But anyway, glad to be back. You know, it's always so great to be part of Newport Greyhound football and be around these kids. So I'm glad to be back.
Randy, we want to talk a little bit. Dan Klopeska, again, is behind the camera, as he has been for the last several years, in the pregame show, as always, has for the last several years, brought to you by Arkansas Steel Associates at 2803 Van Dyke Road. First of all, I want to say best wishes and hope a speedy recovery for Coach Bill Keady, who had some surgery this past week on Monday. He's had a couple of bypasses, had a valve put in his heart, and our thoughts and prayers are with the Keady family as he recovers. He's getting better. He's getting better every day. He's had a little trouble with nausea, but he's a lot better than he was, say, Tuesday or Wednesday. So, my friend, we love you and hope you get well and get home soon.
Absolutely. Get home soon. I know you'd love to be in Los Angeles Saturday night for the in the L.A. Coliseum to see the Red Wolves play. But, you know, take your time, get well, and hopefully we'll see you back in that Red Wolf booth before the year's over.
Randy, when you look, we have a new football coach, new head football coach. Don Harrison has gone. Mark Hinesley has stepped up to the reins, head football coach. Mark is a guy who has been he's been through the wars at Newport, came as an assistant junior high coach, and he has just worked his way to the top.
Absolutely. Glad to see him get the job. You know, he's a guy that loves being in Newport. He and Mallory, you know, just a great family there, and now two children, and glad to have them more permanent part of this Newport scenery, I guess you might say, and I know he's going to do a great job.
Well, he's joined by John Bradley, who is now home at Newport, former head football coach at Cave City, big assistant coach down in Bologna in his early days. But John has joined us. Of course, you saw him earlier on the program. It's always good to have a Newport guy back.
Absolutely. I think they're going to be a great team. I just really was really excited when Coach Hinesley got the job, but even, you know, more excited when I heard that John Bradley was coming home to be the offensive coordinator. I think they will make a great team, and I think there'll be a couple of great coaches.
And Benny Reynolds, Newport's own, and Newport's own Joe Haynes, also on this staff. So there's a lot of Newport blood there, and Mark Hinesley's just like a Newport guy.
Absolutely. You know, he's an old Marvel Academy guy, I guess, but over the last few years, he's become a Greyhound, and I think we've got four Greyhounds there coaching our football team.
Randy, we're going to be different offensively, as John talked about in the pregame, and defensively we're going to be the same, but we're going to obviously try to get the football in Carl Turner's hands. Darren Roddy has looked very, very, very good early on, and matter of fact, in the spring and in the summer workouts, and he's looked real good in the fall.
Yeah, and then, you know, Coach Hinesley calls him thunder and lightning. You know, Carl's got the speed, but he'd just as soon run over you, the real physical back. Darian really got the speed and the moves there, so I think they're a great combination. The wild card there is Ben Collier at quarterback, and, you know, I don't want to know how much we want to run Ben because, you know, the depth situation there maybe, but Ben Collier's a heck of a threat as well.
When you look at Newport, you look at their offensive line is one thing that you talk about, and you say, well, you got to have good blocking up front, no doubt. Sam Bowen, he's a returning starter. Nick Murphy, a returning starter. Caleb Statler, Jordan Mabry at tight end. And then this year, Antonio Gomez, a 6-foot, 255-pound senior, will be the center for this ball club. And then they've got two or three guys who've been vying for position at left tackle, and we'll talk more about that in a little bit. But a veteran offensive line, no doubt.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, when you know, always at the end of the previous year, the thing I start thinking about is who we got coming back next year. You know, the thing I kept going back to is we've got a lot of offensive linemen back, and that's where the offense starts. So, I mean, I'm glad to have that experience back. Another year under the weights for those guys, bigger and stronger, and they know what they're doing. So that's a real strong part of this football team.
First time in 3 years that we will not have Gunner Bullard under center, or at least behind the center in the shotgun formation. Ben Collier takes over there.
Yeah, and then Ben's such a tremendous athlete, such tremendous speed. I mean, I don't know if we've ever had that kind of speed at quarterback before. So like I was, you know, saying earlier, just a tremendous, tremendous threat with Ben running that football. Hopefully, you know, I think he's probably going to get better as we go along throwing the football. I think we may have a good short passing game. We'll see how the long passing game works out. But Ben's going to be a heck of a threat.
O'Shea Pruitt, who is a sophomore, and of course Pruitt name is synonymous in Newport High School athletic history. But O'Shea will be the fullback, and the wings, we said, will be Turner and Roddy. But first of all, we're going to ask our defense to come out here. The Hounds will be kicking off for the first time this year, and a kickoff brought to you by Brian Smith, Farm Bureau Insurance at 206 North Harwood Street, 523-8946. Brian Smith at Farm Bureau. Randy C. with the play-by-play.
That'll be number 17 to Kalen Fryer, sophomore kicking off for Newport. Yeah, I thought a pretty good job in the scrimmage that we had last week when we defeated Valley View 32-27. Nice kick across the middle. And we've got a flag, so offsides against Newport will be that call, I would assume. That'll be a 5-yard penalty. And to Kalen Fry, we'll kick off from the 35.
Well, you don't see that called a lot at any level of football, but no doubt we were offsides there. And I like about the penalty is the hustle of wanting to get down the field.
Yeah, absolutely. And that was a nice kick by Kalen. You know, there's no secret that we've kind of struggled kicking the football the last few years, kickoffs and place kicks and that kind of thing. So, you know, I looked pretty decent.
Randy, this Nettleton football team has never beaten the Greyhounds.
Never have. And been some pretty good football games the last couple of years. They've kind of jumped out on us, I think, last year. We came back and won that football game. And, you know, I think they're an improving football team under Coach Stephen Hampton. Here comes Fryer again to kick from the 35. Ball fielded at the 25. Straight ahead, 35. 40 outside. He brought down by number 64 for Newport. That's Colby McCoy on the tackle. Good field position for Nettleton near midfield.
Well, the Hound defense will come on the field. We've got a lot of guys going both ways, including Sam Bowen and Caleb Statler. Deshaun Anderson will be at a defensive tackle. Nick Murphy, a starter on offense, also at a defensive end. Jordan Mabry and O'Shea Pruitt, linebackers, along with Tyrell Fryer, Jordan Neal, and Tristan Vance said he was going to try to play, even though he's got a broken hand. Ben Collier in the secondary with Darian Roddy.
First and 10 from the 49 for Nettleton. 22, Joe Frazier, the tailback in that offense. Cryte, the quarterback. Straight ahead to Frazier. Frazier with a nice gain up to about the 46-yard line. Gain of 6 on the play, be 2nd and 4 for Nettleton.
Hounds win against Valley View in a football game that was kind of up and down, and John talked about it. We scored two out of the first three plays in the football game, different type of offense. Defensively, Valley View moved the football on us.
Right by himself in the backfield, two receivers left and right. Right keeps it straight ahead, got room. He's got speed. Gets to the outside to the corner, have a first down inside. Well, they'll spot him right just outside the 40, but that'll be enough for Nettleton first down.
Well, one thing that I saw right then, Nettleton, split receiver. He's out there blocking. He got into the secondary, got to that next level, and he's putting a block on a cornerback. If those guys are going to block like that, you got to have linebackers making tackles.
Got to make plays, yes. First and 10, just outside the 40. First drive of the game. We have 11-18 to go in the first quarter, scoreless. Three receivers left, one right. Tried again in the backfield by himself. Motion man. They give it to him outside, number 7. He's got a lot of room, and he'll have a first down and more inside the 20-yard line. That's number 7 for Nettleton, T.C. Cox, a gain of about 22 yards. First down, Nettleton. There's our old neighbor, Lisa Mathis. Of course, her husband, Coach Richie Mathis, line coach for Nettleton. First and 10, Nettleton at the Newport 17.
Well, they got a lot of speed. Quarterback, fullback's a good guy. And of course, Joe Frazier can really go.
Motion man. Hand it off straight ahead. Nice blocking. Nice run up to about the 10-yard line. Gain of nearly 8 on the play. Second and 2. Nettleton moving the ball pretty easily on offense.
Well, when you get that ball, you know, down there inside the 20 and they're going downhill, they punch it hard.
You know that offensive line will be well schooled with Coach Richie Mathis. Second and 3. Right, keeps it up the middle. Played well by the Hound defense. Good job by the defense. Is that big Caleb Statler there, 51. Caleb Statler on the tackle on that defensive line. Brings up third down and very short.
10:23 to play here in the opening quarter. Remind everybody the games could be seen on cable15tv.com, www.cable15tv.com.
Third and 4. And Crike by himself, two receivers each way. He keeps it to the left side, the strong side. He's got a lot of room inside the 10. He brought down inside the 5 at the 5-yard line, first and goal for the Nettleton Raiders.
Well, again, they got a great block from their split receiver, one of their wideouts coming back. And he didn't really crack on the corner. The corner was coming hard because it was his responsibility for the quarterback, and they just got us blocked then.
First and goal from the 5, 9:58 to go in the first quarter. We're scoreless. Frazier will be in the backfield behind Crite. Motion man, number 5. Crite keeps it. He brought down at the 2-yard line, gain of 3. Number 52 on the play for Newport. That's Tyler Linville on the tackle. Second and goal.
Big senior dominating offensive line. Those guys have played together for a couple of years. Anytime you've got 5 seniors up there, you've got a good crew.
Second and goal from the 2. Frazier straight ahead. Touchdown, Nettleton. Joe Frazier, a 2-yard touchdown run. Nettleton 6, Newport 0, 9:19 to go in the first quarter.
Well, Nettleton didn't do anything fancy other than just line up and control the line of scrimmage. And they take advantage of their big size against our undersized defensive linemen.
Nettleton will attempt the extra point. That's Ethan Edgar, the kicker, soccer style. Ball down, kick is up in the air, and it is good. And with 9:19 to go in the first quarter, Nettleton 7, Newport 0.
Folks, if you want great gasoline, Shell V-Power Premium Natural Gasoline is now available at Shell Newport Food Mart. They're located on Highway 367 North across from Merchants and Planters Bank and in front of the Cable 15 television office. And we talk about fried chicken, which is simply as good as you can get anywhere in the country. You can get it by the piece. You can get it by the snack box. You can get all you want. Got a big order, you might have to call that thing in or at least go by and tell them you want a big order and you'll come pick it up later. Plus, go by and register for the BMWs. They're giving away 100, not necessarily this store, but the stores nationwide, 100 BMWs in 100 days. It's a giveaway, and all you got to do is register at the Newport Shell Food Mart.
Be a heck of a deal if they've given 100 away in Newport, wouldn't it?
That'd be a heck of a deal, wouldn't it?
Ethan Edgar, who just made it 7-0 with the extra point, will kick off.
We'll
Turner and Roddy deep.
Just saying, we'll be looking for a brand body shop collision of the week throughout the course of the night.
Edgar's kick. Carl will field it at the 18. Carl Turner. Straight ahead, Carl Turner. Still on his feet, an excellent return. Newport, great field position at the 41. Carl just a shoestring away from going all the way. First down, Newport at the 42.
Well, this is his swan song for the Greyhounds. He's a four-year starter, which we haven't had many of those. I don't remember any, to tell you the truth.
I can't remember any.
A couple of times All-State, just a phenomenal football player. He's in shape. He's ready. He's going to run the football hard.
And first and 10, Newport at the 43. We've got to match these guys scoring, I think. Ben Collier, number 10, is your quarterback. Turner, Roddy, the wings. Carl in motion. They'll toss it to him. Carl will be brought down for a loss back at the 41, 42-yard line. Loss of about one on the play. Second down, 11. O'Shea Pruitt in the game at the running back position. Again, the double wing look for Newport. Obviously something new for us, brought in by Coach John Bradley. He's had a lot of success with that at Cave City.
Jay Kratt, one of the wideouts for the Hounds, or the wideout.
And off to Roddy. Can't quite get through there. He'll be get back to the original line of scrimmage, make it third down and 10, just a step away from getting through there, but brought down by shoestring, third and 10.
Little delayed trap play to Roddy that time, and the Hounds are going to use that as a bread and butter. Congratulations to the Pups last night on a big victory over Nettleton.
Great victory. Congratulations to Coach Kyle Hare and his staff, his first career victory there. A touchdown pass with 20 seconds to go. A very exciting football game. Cash Forrester and JT Haynes. Third and 10, big play, guys. We don't want to give it right back to them. Boy, just stuffed in the backfield. Nothing there. That was O'Shea Pruitt, and he's stopped at the line of scrimmage. And the Ham will get no first down and will have to punt it away on the first drive.
Well, if you're Nettleton and you're the defensive staff, when you're against this type of offense, it is so key to stay in position and just play your spot as opposed to chasing those guys who go in motion. And that Nettleton was very disciplined on that defensive series.
Carl Turner will be the punter. Assume that's Zach Altman. Yeah, Zach Altman is the deep snapper.
Zach's working with a broken bone, a fractured bone in a hand.
Oh, snap. Carl has to go to knee, and Carl's going to run it. Needs a block, and he's not going to get it. And Carl will be brought down after about a three-yard gain, and Nettleton will have it first and 10 with excellent field position at the Newport 46.
Well, he had some time to punt.
Plenty of time, yeah.
After he picked it up, but he elected to run, and the Newport defense will be called on. And see if we can stop this offense that looked pretty good in their first drive. 65 years experience at Medical Park Orthopedic and Sports Medicine Clinic at 501 Virginia Drive, Suite C, Batesville, 870-793-2371. Dr. Carpenter, Dr. Angel, and Dr. J.D. Allen, Medicare, Medicaid, and Blue Cross Blue Shield accepted at Medical Park Orthopedic and Sports Medicine Clinic.
Five in motion, Trite, hands it to five, gets a great block and takes it outside. Boy, nice gain of about eight out there. He's second and two for Nettleton.
Well, there was a holding out there that they didn't call against Tyrell Fryer. The guy had just, you know, when you grab him up and tackle the guy and the referee was looking right at it, we don't get a call there. See, I missed that one.
Jaron Northern on the carry for a gain of eight, second and two. And Kobe Cried, the quarterback. He is related to Kristen Crichton, and some of those. Frazier in motion. Got a flag on the play, and hopefully that's illegal procedure against Nettleton. That'll be a 5-yard penalty, and that'll help make it second down and eight.
You know, we'll have Coach Mark Hinesley on at the end of the broadcast each and every week to talk about how the Hounds did on Friday night. Of course, the show's always brought to you by Subway in the Walmart Supercenter. And a great deal at Subway is the Reuben sandwich with sauerkraut. It is so delicious. If you haven't tried it, get to Subway and try it. Kraut on a Reuben.
Kraut keeps it straight ahead. Played well by the Hound defense. That's a little bit better, guys. That's a lot better. Short gain, third down, and about four, maybe five.
Now you'd think even down at the 40-yard line, 41 possibly, they're at the 40. Down to the 40, you think it'd be four down territory for Nettleton. You know, we just need to hold them. Hey, let's hold them right here.
Yeah, just hold them. And either way, we want to take our chances, whether it's a punt or going for it. Might want to make them make that decision. Try it alone. We've got a flag on the play, and the procedure gets.
Got light out on the far side over there. Okay. He just jumped just a little too quickly.
I thought it had to be on them, but it looked like he was pointing his arm the other way. But that is against Nelson. 5-yard penalty. May put him in a passing situation. Be third down and right at 10, maybe 9, long 9.
Well, third goes from third and 4 to third and 9.
Kreit limps off the field.
Wow.
And that'll make – and they're kind of confused now. They don't have a quarterback, and they're going to – well, number 9 is the quarterback. He was looking for the pass. DeAndre Henry, he's just a sophomore. If we can put a little heat on him, Joe Frazier will line up behind him in the backfield. And they're going to call a timeout and talk about this.
Well, anytime your quarterback goes out, I mean, there's got to be a little confusion. And obviously there was some confusion. But timeout on the field with 5:40 to play. We trail 7-0. Robert Turner, 62 in your program, number one in your heart, 1420 McLean Street. But he won't be there much longer. These guys, Robert and Dad Mike, are building him a nice facility out on Stegall Road. So if you see the new construction going up there, you know that Robert Turner and Papa Mike are building him a nice building. And nice to see some construction going on in Newport, Arkansas. But hometown service, Wise Investments, Robert Turner, 523-8780. The game's also brought to you by ASU Newport. You can start now at ASU Newport. You can find a new career and be on the path of success with programs like diesel technology, renewable energy, surgical technology, commercial truck driving, high voltage lineman technology, practical nursing, and more. Stay close to home and get hands-on training at affordable prices, plus financial aid is available for those who qualify.
Nettleton comes out of the timeout again, number 9, the sophomore quarterback. His first play at quarterback as a senior high member. Probably wouldn't look for him to throw here, but you never know. Got Frazier right to his left. And he is going to throw it. Drops back, little pump fake, throws it deep, has a man open. Great defense by the Hounds. It'll be fourth down, and they will punt it with fourth and 10, I would think. Yeah, punt team coming out. Good job by that Hound defense.
Yeah, great job. You know, you're talking about ASU Newport, Randy, and, you know, the motto's always been a great place to start, and indeed it is. I mean, we're just – they have a college right there in Newport, and what that college brings to our community is just – it's big, big, big. If you need information on any of the programs that they have out there, don't wait. You can apply now and start your future. You can visit asun.edu and click on Apply Now, or give them a call at 512-7800.
Don't jump, guys. Make him punt the football. It's number 40 kicking for Nettleton. Christian Hightower. Good snap. Short kick. Just stay away from it. Hound should have decent field position. They're going to spot it at about the – we'll see where he lines up outside the 20. At the 24-yard line, first down, Newport. 5:24 to go in the first quarter. We trail 7-0.
Yeah, Nettleton's 1 out of 2 on their offensive series, and certainly our defense was helped by their offense's penalties that they had. And the Newport offense, we've got to move the football. We've got to move some clock, move the ball, get some first downs, and do a little better job of executing on this drive. But I know John Bradley, he's just one of those Newport guys who is excited to be here, and he'll get this offense rolling.
I feel that way, too. First and 10 from the 24.
Double doubles.
Hand off inside. They're gain up to, well, it's still Powell still going forward. Past the 30-yard line, gain of about 6 seconds, four good power by the Hounds. Not sure who gets up off the bottom of that pile. It was O'Shea Pruitt, the young sophomore. Nice gain on first down. You always like to see that. Gives you a lot more options. And being in the hole. Jay Kreit wide left. No snap. Ben keeps it straight ahead. No gain. He'll be brought down at the line of scrimmage. 31-yard line. A big play right here. Third down and long four for Newport.
Well, when you're playing a school that's a couple of classifications above you, and these guys are a 5A and we're actually a 3A, you got to be able to execute. You can't have negative plays like that or plays that you don't gain very much, and just a mishandled snap right there. But third down and short. Let's convert right here, Randy C.
Yeah. Let's go, guys. Give your defense a little bit of a rest here, although some of you are both ways, certainly. Carl in motion. Toss to Carl. Boy, they just swarm him. They're just – everybody's ready for Carl, ready for the play, and loss of two on the play. Fourth down and eight for Newport.
Hounds will punt, obviously, with 3:50 to play in the first quarter, trailing 7-0. We'll see if Kreit makes it back onto the field.
Number eight goes deep. Dre Nesby and Carl Turner to punt the football. Zach Alton to snap. O'Shea Pruitt is the front man. Good snap. Carl. Kick will be nice roll for Newport to about the 35-yard line. So pretty good punt by Carlby. First and 10 for Nettleton. At their own 35-yard line.
Well, in hopes the defense comes in here and can force another punt, maybe, you know, switch the field over and turn the field over for the Hound offense. Hound offense, no first downs yet, but still early in the football game. 3:19 to play in the first. We trail 7-0.
In fact, the young sophomore will still be in the game at quarterback. So, number nine, DeAndre Henry. Again, Kobe Kreit, not sure of the injury, some type of leg injury. First and 10 at the 35. Hand off to Frazier, going outside. 15 on the play for Newport. That's not sure who that was.
Colton O'Dell.
Okay.
A young man had just moved back to Newport, Chad O'Dell.
Okay.
Family. And
good to have Chad back around. Second and five.
Kid's going to be a great football player.
And off inside. They'll have a first down. Nice. Nothing fancy with the young quarterback in there. They'll pick up 6 yards seven to the 47. First and 10, Nettleton. 2:29 to go in the first quarter. Nettleton leads 7-0 and on the move.
I want to remind everybody that White River area on aging has moved to 1200 Highway 367 North in Newport next to Glass Plus, formerly Reba's Uniforms. White River area agency on aging. They rent our building there on 2600 Doyle and wanted to move out on the highway, so they're out there right beside Glass Plus.
Off straight ahead to Frazier. Played well by Statler. And plenty of help to wrap him up. Caleb Statler with the initial contact and then several others to finish that off. Number 16 in on the play, Tydrell Fryer, another sophomore.
Well, that's just good gang tackling by the Hound defense and a little excitement in the air on that play.
Well, Statler must have just whipped his guy up front because he was right in the backfield.
He can do that.
He can do it. You know, Caleb did a heck of a job on the guy from Star City last year, the Caps kid, I guess was his name.
Absolutely.
Second down and 15. Quarterback straight back, a little flare out of the backfield to Frazier. Plenty of hounds there. We've got to make a tackle, and we do. Good job, Nick Murphy and others there. Brings up third and long.
Well, played well by Darren Moore. Also, and Jordan Neal in the secondary, making Frazier cut back inside where Newport had some help. Brings up third down and about 13, a long 13.
Let's go defense. And they threw it deep. last time. Kreitz up walking around. We see him on the sideline, so he may be back pretty soon. He'd make a stop right here. All right, he's still limping a little bit, though. Flag, and that'll make it third and even longer. Was that substitution or was that delay?
It was not delay, maybe a substitution.
Yeah, it's substitution. I mean, that didn't look like a delay call, but I didn't really know what it was. I think probably some type of substitution violation. Third down and long. They've got to get to the Newport 43. So third and 18. Come on, defense. Nothing cheap here.
Keep everything in front.
Absolutely. Frazier lines up to the right of the quarterback. Motion man this way. Straight back. Those little wide receiver screen played well by the Hounds. Just make a tackle. Great job by the defense. Dave, there were four Hounds around that play.
Well, I think we knew what was coming because we had that play perfectly. And the Hounds did tackle there in open field, and that's going to be the end of the first quarter, Randy C.
Well, got off for a relatively easy Nettleton drive to start the game. But I tell you what, this Newport defense has played well on the last two series. And that's the end of the first quarter. Nettleton leads 7-0.
I want to remind everybody that the ball game brought to you by the Kirtner Lumber Company at the Newport Air Base since 1967. And Clay Kirtner and all the family always wishing the Hounds the very best. Old Greyhound Clay Kirtner and Zach Kirtner and Melissa and Jennifer and, you know, cheerleaders and football players and athletes and the Kirtner family at the Newport Air Base. And of course, NEDC, and what a job John Chadwell and his group is doing down there. And and now that the Newport Chamber, you know, they're down there in the NEDC building, and they've kind of combined their assets together as far as their personnel, and they're working together. And of course, it's a great, great little city. Everybody works together. That's the thing that John and I talk a lot about on the Business Spotlight, is how well everybody works together. And NEDC is at the forefront of bringing jobs, bringing industry, more jobs for local industry. Those guys do a fantastic job, and don't anybody going to argue with me.
Absolutely. You know, for a town this size, there's not another Economic Development Commission chamber like ours. You know, I, of course, retired from Extension Service, and our community development staff would always make examples out of Newport and what John Chadwell and his crew was doing. I mean, they would talk about those guys at meetings around the state, what's happening in Newport. Punt situation for Newport. I mean, for Nettleton, hopefully we can get some decent field position here. Good snap. No heat. Good kick. We're just going to stay away from that. Hopefully he takes a bounce back this way so the Hounds will have decent field position at the 26, first and 10, Newport.
Randy Nettleton and the Hounds have played 13 times since 1979, as we mentioned earlier, and there's a flag back down here at the 45-yard line. We'll have to sort that out. But Nettleton has never beaten the Hounds the last 3 years. And last year it was 46-31 Newport. Year before that, 28-7 and 38-32 in 2012. Hounds have dominated the series. 50th year of football for Nettleton. Beautiful AstroTurf field that they have here. And going to have a big celebration at halftime. We won't be a part of that, but
we'll get a long break.
Football.
We'll get a 25-minute break at halftime. Gets 28 if you count the 3-minute mandatory warm-up, which I assume will follow that. Well, the officials are really talking this over. I don't know what's – no indication of what it might be, and no emotion from anybody on either team that would give any kind of idea of what it might be.
Yeah, they're talking about post-possession, pre-possession.
Holding against Newport. It'll be first down Newport. I guess they may mark it off after the – from where it was called dead at. That's actually going to be marked off against. I'm a little confused, David.
I'm a little confused, too. Well, he called it against Newport. He pointed Newport, and then they marked it off against Nettleton.
So
we'll take it.
Yeah. Apparently, he just pointed the wrong way because Nettleton's not arguing about marking it 5 yards forward. So
come on, Hounds. Let's go right here.
We got to move the football here, guys. I mean, I was looking for the strength of this team to be the offense, and I think it still will be, but we got to show something here. No first downs yet for this football team. Carr will spread out a little bit this time. Different look.
Yeah, double doubles.
Carr back in motion. Hand off inside. And that's O'Shea again, and O'Shea with a positive play. two best plays of the game so far have been O'Shea carries on first down. He'll get probably about three, maybe four, second down and six for Newport.
Well, this offense is designed to get 3.5, 4 yards per carry and chew up some clock, and that's just that's a good football play right there.
Yeah, we haven't had one of those kind of offenses in a while, kind of hard to get used to, where you grind out the first downs. We haven't ground out the first one yet, but I think this offense will do that throughout the season.
Dalton Mentley in at tight end. What an addition he's been to the football team.
Glad to have him back. Player.
Yeah.
Back in the double wing. Carl in motion. Ben, gonna throw it. He got a man over at Mentley. 30. Dalton Mentley, 35. Mentley, 40. Mentley, 41 yard line. First down, Newport, I think. Yes. First down, Newport at the 41.
Catcher on the baseball team. Great hands. Dalton with a big, big reception right there. Close to a first down, and they're gonna call it first down. First down for the Hounds. I just mentioned Dalton being in the game.
Yeah. He was out there for a reason.
Yeah.
He's out now. Hopefully that'll loosen things up a little bit. First and 10, Newport at their own 41.
Hounds lead 7, or the Hounds trail 7-0. I might have said the Hounds lead 7-0 early. Hounds trail 7-0.
Roddy in motion. Ben keeps it straight ahead. He'll lose one back to the 40-yard line. Well, just hard to get anything going inside. No gain, second and 11 at the 40.
Lindley Health and Rehab, 326 Lindley Lane. If you haven't seen any of their videos on Cable Channel 15 TV, make sure you go to cable15tv.com and click on Lindley Videos and watch some of the great videos. They do a marvelous job out there of including their residents in the videos, whether it's a watermelon eating contest or celebrating a 100-year birthday like they did with Miss Viola Peebles. It's exciting at Lindley.
They have fun.
They do.
Second and 11, being straight back. Throws it across middle, it's picked off. And he'll be brought down at the 46-yard line. The first and 10, Nelson, that's number 40, the punter on that interception. Read it perfectly, threw it thrown right in his hands. That was Christian Hightower. Big break for Nettleton.
Turnovers are always big in the football game, and that one goes against the Hounds, and great field position as they'll start out down at the 46-yard line.
David, you were talking about execution. You know, I've been listening to, obviously, some talk about the ASU-USC game, and they talk about how important it is for ASU to execute, because a team like USC will just jump right on you with any kind of missed execution. And, you know, that's what happens when you play some of these bigger schools. Crite back in the game at quarterback, number 6. Frazier behind him. Frazier gets outside, and we had plenty of chances to make a play, and we were not able to, and there's a flag on the play. Is that an illegal block or?
Of anything, I'm not sure.
I didn't see a face mask, but
face mask, it
could have been. I mean, that's the only thing it would be against Newport, I would think. And I think that's what it is. No, holding against Nettleton. That'll negate that play, 10-yard penalty.
I talked earlier in the broadcast about those split receivers, the wideouts getting on our cornerbacks and staying with the blocks. So if you lock up with them and you grab them, you just hope you get that call. If you're driving a guy straight back, it's hard to call, but if you've got a defender trying to go side to side and he's pulling jersey, then it's easy to call.
And off to the left side, gets a great block on the corner there, brought down from behind. Good pursuit. Not sure who that was, David. Did you get that number? Number 4 for Newport, that's Jordan Mabry. Big second down and 7. Let there be light in the press box.
I feel like I can broadcast.
We can actually read now.
I can see.
Never even thought about it. 72 in the game for Newport on that defensive front. That's Darrell Hardman.
Big kid.
He's a sophomore, and he's going to be a great one.
Has a chance to be a great one.
All the potential in the world. Hand off straight ahead. Nelson will have a first down at the 35-yard line.
Nettleton 8:47 to play. Clock stops as they move the chains. Nettleton leads in the football game 7-0.
Already executing a little bit better with Pride in the game, first string quarterback.
Stopped into the Sonic last night and had me a double hot dog. Coney Island, they said they come in a foot long. I said, give me a couple of feet of that. Sonic Drive-In, Newport. America's Drive-In,
motion.
Sonic.
Five outside, played well by the Hounds. Big hit there. It's at 52 on the play for Newport. That's Tyler Linville playing well for the sophomore. Boy, they've been talking about Sonic had to have two grape Sprites today. Actually, I ordered a grape lemonade, and they gave me a grape Sprite, and it was pretty good. So I came back and
had another one.
Yeah. Maddie Shelton brought it out there both times. I had two different trucks, and she didn't know what was going on. But anyway.
You're drinking heavy these days,
aren't you? Drinking heavy when it's hot and you're working,
yeah,
man. I'm telling you. Second down and 7. Let's go defense. Hand off outside. Frazier. Well, played well. Is that Odell? Colton Odell with a heck of a defensive play, number 15. I'm
tough
glad we got him, kid. David.
Tough looking guy.
Sophomore Colton Odell played that very well. Bring up 3rd down and 4. Obviously 4 down territory now, no question. But we could make it 4 down territory with a big sack. And our Hounds are going to jump offside. That's what the play was designed for, and that'll give Nettleton a first down inside the Newport 25 at the 24. We have 7:06 remaining in the first half. Nettleton leads 7-0.
Dr. Gavin McDowell, Customized Vision Care, located in the Village Mall. Their phone number is 523-3333. Professional Vision Care and Eye Health Care. Name brand glasses, name brand sunglasses. Got great selection and guaranteed contact lens program at Dr. Gavin McDowell. Customized Vision Care in the Newport Village Mall.
1st and 10 at the 24. Motion.
Looking for a brand body shop collision of the week.
Pratt keeps it straight ahead and sneaks through the pile there and gets a nice gain of about 4 to the 22nd and 6. Leader in the clubhouse will be Tyler Linville. Hopefully we're going to have some more big licks. 2nd and 6 at the 20.
I love our effort. Our effort's
yeah,
there.
We're,
6.5
well.
To play first half. We trail 7-0.
Yeah, I wasn't real excited about the first drive Nettleton had, but since then I've been pretty pleased with this football team. Just got to get something broken loose offensively, and that will happen. Straight ahead. Well, Frazier's running hard, and he breaks out of that tackle. And, boy, he's down near the 1 yard line. Tough running by Joe Frazier.
Yeah, he broke a tackle at about the 18-yard line. He broke another one at the 15, and he's just running over folks. And official timeout, or timeout by Newport.
Timeout Newport.
6:09
yeah.
to play here in the first half. We trail 7-0, but it's been a good football
game.
Yeah,
I think
we
played well. Again, just want to make something happen offensively. If we can't do that, it turn into a long night, but surely that's going to change.
St. Michael's Place at 1311 North Pecan Street. You know, they provide nursing home, skilled nursing, they're a skilled nursing facility. Staff at St. Michael's Place Incorporated provide personalized services designed to meet the needs of every patient. The dedicated health professionals offer the assistance you need while respecting your independence. St. Michael's Place accepts admissions 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. I'd say that's about every day of the year at St. Michael's Place on North Pecan Street. And I want to talk about the city of Newport and remind you once again about the recycling center. They're open and you can drop off stuff even after hours, whether it's newspapers or magazines or plastic, tin cans, aluminum. They offer a free paper shredding service. Call ahead of time if you have large amounts, 217-0070. The City of Newport and the Recycling Center. Use the Recycling Center.
1st and goal. Frazier snuffed in the backfield. Boy, a loss back to the 5-yard line. Great penetration by the Newport Greyhounds. Deshaun Anderson, others in the play. O'Shea was around there. loss of about 3.5 yards. They were at the 1.5, now back outside the 5, loss of only almost 4 on the play. Like something happened, defense. How about a turnover?
5:45, clock moving. First half, we trail Nettleton 7-0.
Frazier to the left side, and he will go in the end zone. Joe Frazier, 5-yard touchdown run. 5:28 to go in the first quarter. Nettleton leads 13-0.
Well, again, just an excellent job by the Nettleton offensive line. You coach for Coach Richie Mathis. We talked about Coach Mathis earlier, and boy, they're just senior laden, and they're experienced, and they're pretty solid up front. So a couple of scores down right here with the extra point to follow.
And number 15, Ethan Edgar, attempt the extra point. Ball down, kicks up in the air, and it looks good, and it is good. And with 5:28 to go in the first half, it's Nettleton 14, Newport 0.
Booster Club luncheon on Monday at Unity Health Medical Center. And you say, hey, where's the Unity Health Medical Center? Well, it's former Harris Hospital, and it's where healing begins. Unity Health Harris Medical Center, same people, new name, located at 1205 McLean Street. Darren Caldwell is the new vice president of Unity Health. There in Newport, he was awarded that position on August or mid-August. Met him the other day at the touchdown luncheon, and a fine young man. We'll be interviewing him for the Business Spotlight this coming week. Unity Health, Harris Medical Center in Newport. Don't forget about the Booster Club touchdown luncheon. It'll be, if you're watching on Saturday or Sunday, it will be Tuesday as opposed to Monday, with Monday coming up being a holiday. So the touchdown luncheon at Unity Health Medical Center will be Tuesday at noon. Coach Hansley, and he'll bring some of his other coaches, and they talk about the previous week's ball game and what they have to look forward to next week. Schedule doesn't get any easier for the Hounds.
No, this non-conference is murderer's row. Coach Hansley will have, I assume, players of the week this week as well, since we've had a game. We'll have had a game. Edgar with the kick. Boy, deep kick. Go into the end zone, and Hounds have it first and 10 at their own 20. And that's a dead ball,
it
once it goes
ball.
In the end zone. Yeah.
Anytime the ball goes in the end zone, high school football, it's a dead ball.
Yeah.
I don't know what the official was thinking, unless the rule has changed this year. It's always been a dead ball. But at least Carl Turner had the presence of mind to didn't hear a whistle. And, you know, tonight, I've noticed that even when they tackle people, both defensive tackle people, you don't hear a lot of whistles.
Yeah.
I noticed it last night at the junior high game. They never blew the whistle. They would have plays where they didn't blow it at all.
I noticed that last night.
Yeah.
Sure did.
If they're going to give you a whistle, you blow it when the play's dead.
That's what it's
to let
for,
everybody
yeah.
to let everybody else know the play is dead.
Absolutely.
If you don't blow it, kids are going to play hard.
They're pretty important for this offense to get something going here. I mean, we're going to wake up and get going. We don't want to fall behind anymore. The Hounds will get the ball to start the second half, so it'll be really nice to have a scoring drive here. First and 10 at the 20. Carl. 2 yards to the 22-yard line. Second and 8 for Newport. Boy, just tough sledding inside against this Nettleton defensive group.
Playing assignment football and staying at home when they need to stay at home, and chasing the football when they need to chase it. 14-0 Nettleton with 4:50 to play here in the first half.
Darren Moore at one of those running back positions, one of the wing positions, along with Roddy. We had two men in motion. That'll be a flag. Had a new wing back in the game, and a little confusion there. Not sure whose fault it was, but we had some confusion. Two men in motion. That'll be a 5-yard penalty and make it second and 13.
Those are type mistakes that can be corrected with a little work, a little coaching.
All spotted back. Just a 19-yard line. Call it closer to second and 11. Again, Hounds have to get to the 30-yard line.
You know, I mentioned earlier, Randy, about the Hounds being a 3A school. We're playing a 4A schedule this year, but the new cycle that's coming up has us in AAA.
Yeah.
And that means what you were 3 and 4 years ago is the count. So we've been, you know, playing with AAA numbers and playing in 4A, and this is a 5A school and a big one.
Ben's in deep trouble, and he'll be brought down for a loss of about 10 or 11 yards inside the 10, back at about the 9, and it's going to be 3rd and 21, and there's not a good answer for that down in distance. Now just really struggling to get untracked offensively, no doubt about it. No first downs. Maybe one first down. Yes, I remember that now. Yeah. One first down for the Hounds. Let's pull off a good one here. Let's make 21 and get a first down.
Well, our bunch is capable.
I mean, I have no doubt about the capabilities. You know, we're playing a good football team. We just haven't clicked yet, but there's no doubt about the potential of this bunch. Carl running hard. He fumbles the football. Nelson will pick it up, and it's blown dead. It's blown dead, and we'll punt the football. Newport will punt it. Line of scrimmage will be the 13-yard line.
With 3:40 to play, let's see if the clock starts.
Clock should be spinning. If
it does when they start it, it is going. We need to stay in the huddle for a little while. 25-second clock is just now going, and we don't need to snap it here. We need to run the 25-second clock down to 3 or 4.
Carl with a pretty good kick. Be fielded at the 41, drops it. And he'll field it and be 1st and 10. Nettleton at the Newport 40. Great field position. Plenty of time. 3:18 to go in the first quarter. Hounds trail 14-0.
You might ask, why would you want to run the 25-second clock down? Well, you're fixing to give Nettleton the football in pretty good field position. And instead of 3:18 to play, you could have had at least 18 more of those seconds run off. Let's hope that the 18 doesn't hurt us here and the Hound defense can put a stop on the Nettleton offense. Jackson's Funeral Home, the 1900 block of Malcolm Avenue. Our family serving your family. The Jackson's Funeral Home. Caring comfort in your family's time of need at the Jackson Funeral Home. Greenway Equipment Company in Newport, your John Deere dealer. Proud to sponsor Greyhound football here on Cable Channel 15 TV. GoGreenway.com for all your farm equipment needs.
1st and 10, Nettleton at the 43, receivers this way. A little bit of confusion.
Number one seven in the gets slot here is ineligible back at the bottom of the screen. The second guy is ineligible.
You know, side and nice gain up to about the 34-yard line. That's Joe Frazier on the carry. We'll give him 6.
Wasn't Kenny Norton?
No, not
George Foreman.
Muhammad Ali.
Joe Frazier.
I whip Joe Frazier.
I whip Kenny Norton. I don't want Kenny Norton. I don't want George Foreman. I want Joe Frazier. Joe Frazier. The thrill in Manila. Come on, Hounds. 3:10 clock moving. First half, we trail 14-0. We got to have a stop right here.
Off to 5. Odell with the pursuit. Colton will bring him down, but not before he gets a first down. That was number 5 on the carry once again. That's Jaron Northern. He's just a sophomore, but you can tell he can scoot.
Well, it was one of those weeks that I didn't see you at El Puente. I know you went out there. I just must have missed
you. Yeah, you don't ever come on Wednesday. Wednesday's our usual night there, man.
Wednesday night out with the Klopetskas.
Wednesday night and Sunday after church.
Great food.
Those two times are pretty much every week. I think we got a flag against Nettleton. That's another hole.
Big plus for the Hounds.
Yeah. There we go.
El Puente with, well, the fajita taco salads. The fajitas are outstanding. Yeah. I don't know of anything that you order on the menu that you go, hey, you know, I'm not going to order that anymore.
Yeah.
It's all good.
I've been getting the Super Nacho Fajitas. I've been getting it meatless, and I've been having them add mushrooms, and that's really good.
Really?
Yep. Paula's been getting mushroom quesadillas, and I've been getting the Super Nacho Fajitas with mushrooms instead of meat, so we're loving that. There's the heat, and he's brought down for a loss.
See, no whistle there. Still haven't
still no
whistle.
Whistle. The play's not dead, I guess.
Well, and you got guys at the offensive line who are still blocking defensive linemen. You got defensive linemen who are still playing. I don't know. Maybe it's a new rule in high school football.
you don't blow the whistle.
They didn't blow it last night.
I noticed that last night. I know where you're coming from because I was wondering about the same thing. That was Jordan Mabry and Nick Murphy.
Or huge for the Hounds to stop right here with 2:10.
Look at the Hound fans. I love that.
Yeah.
Making some noise over there. 3rd and 20. Come on, defense.
Well, we need to stop.
straight inside. Frazier, good play by the defense, and Nelson will have to punt. Good job, Hound defense, and good job, Newport fans.
Nick Murphy, among others, on the stop.
Be fourth down and 19. Surely they're going to punt it.
And you had to decide there if you were going to call timeout. You got a couple of them left. Or do you just want to go into the half and regroup?
I mean, Nelton hasn't even brought their punter in there. I don't know why you would not want to pin Newport back deep. Why would you want to give them to ball at midfield with a minute to go? But they're lining up as if they're going to go.
They're going to run the 25-second clock down and call timeout. That's what I thought Newport was going to do a while ago, is at least that takes some time off the clock by doing so.
Yeah, they're going to punt it. See, Coach, I don't know if you can see him or not, Coach Pat Massey down there with the special teams.
Been doing it a long time?
Been doing it a long time, yeah. Of course, Coach Pat Massey, the brother of Ward Massey, who I can't say lives on Nancy Avenue anymore because they moved, and Coach Bradley now lives in that house, which I'm tickled to death, but certainly miss Sandra and Ward Massey on my street. But got the Nancy Avenue connection there. You also got Coach Richie Mathis, who was my next-door neighbor when I moved there 27 years ago. Is Wade Massey still helping with football?
I thought so, yeah.
I haven't seen him, but that's another.
Alma
Massey lived on Nancy Avenue.
Sure
so
did, she?
That's the Nancy Avenue connection on that sideline.
Yes, sir.
All right, guys, stay home. No mistakes here. Hope for a bad punt and some good field position. Number 40 with the punt. It's a good punt. We just need to stay away. Colton Odell with a great job of fielding the punt. You know, David Newport has a history of not fielding punts. Good to see Colton take care of that.
Well, that's otherwise, one of those deals that you got to have confidence that you can do it. And obviously, when he called for the fair catch, you could just tell that was a confident young man. You have a minute four to work with. You got a couple of timeouts. Newport saves their timeouts. Let's see what happens here.
If Colton doesn't catch that, we're probably around the five-yard line.
Absolutely right.
And anything could happen, and usually bad in that field position.
We just need some good, positive plays right here to end the half.
You know, we've got guys that could break it on any down. Carl in motion. Toss to Carl. Carl running hard. Short gain on the play up to the 20-yard line. Be second down. And we'll have to run at least one more play here. 44 seconds to go in the first half. 25-second clock at 23. So possibly just one more play here. We'd love to see an 80-yard touchdown run by somebody. A little different look offensively here. Three receivers left, one right. Ben rolls this way. Got pursuit, in trouble, and he'll be brought down. And Nelson will have the football with 15.3 seconds to go. And, boy, they stopped that clock and pretty quickly, make sure he got a little extra time. Yeah. Nelson has the football.
Merchants and Planters Bank, main office, 2nd Hazel Street, north office on Highway 367 North, several locations throughout northeast and north central Arkansas. Don't forget about M&P Insurance and Investment Services, home insurance, life and health insurance, property and casualty, auto insurance, Medicare supplements, crop insurance, you name it. M&P at www.mnpbank.com. Norman Baker Pharmacy, Mary Davis and crew at 1117 McLean Street, 523-9472. And if you don't like to walk in somewhere to get your medicine, just drive through, do a little business with Norman Baker Pharmacy.
Huge defensive series for the Hounds here, and we've got motion now. Nelson will have to move back 5 yards, be first and 10 from the 26. We have 15.3 seconds to go in the half. Again, a critical series for the Hounds. We don't want to go down three scores going into the half. Would make it very difficult. Although we did come back from a 21-0 deficit in one game last year. Frazier, and we've got a flag again. That's going to be five more against Nelton, and the Nelton coaches will not be happy. And I see Coach Mathis with a little emotion. Remember, used to see that on the Newport sideline several times. Back to the 31-yard line, first and 20 from the 31. Got a little clock, 3.2 seconds on that play. 12.1 to go in the half. Again, just got to stop them short of that goal line. And they're not going to go to a knee. Well, yes, they are. That's kind of surprising, David, and I don't know why you would do that at the 30-yard line.
It's going to be 14-0. The Hounds are going to trail in the
We'll first, take it.
First half comes to an end. A reminder that Farmers Tire Mart's located at 1501 Malcolm. Tires caught for your cars, trucks, trailers, ATV, lawnmowers, automobile service, including oil changes, tire rotation, belt hoses, front end work, brakes. And you can reach them at Facebook.com or www.farmerstiremart.com, or you can give them a call at 523-6735. Tommy Bain and family, owner-operator. Kell Motors, Highway 367 North, the lead sponsor for Remember When. Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, 523-2792. Get all their inventory on the web at www.georgekellmotors.com. We trail 14-0, Randy C. Second half's coming right up. We want to remind everybody that if you're watching the game Saturday morning, Sunday night, or Tuesday night, you can watch the game at any time you want to watch it, and tell your friends about us about at cable15tv.com. It's www.cable15tv.com, but you don't have to put in the www. You can just Google cable15tv. A lot of good programming on there, and a couple of automobile shows and the business spotlights and things that we have done recently, and that's where we keep our whole library. But you can watch the games there, and I get a lot of folks from Facebook that say that they enjoyed watching the game. So it'll be on Facebook, too, on my account, just David Black. But, Randy C., not a lot of offense to talk about for the Hounds. We got shut out in the first half and really didn't move the ball that well, but still down just 14-0.
Yeah, you know, still a football game. We get the ball to start the second half, and we can make something happen offensively. You know, I really thought going in that offense would be the strong suit of this football team, and I think it probably very well will be. It's just – you know, tough getting going. It's a good Nettleton front, especially on the, you know, the front seven's very, very good, and we're just having a hard time getting going, you know, one first down. But I think that'll come defensively. I've been pretty pleased. You know, the first drive, they kind of went down the field pretty easily. But after that, I thought our defense settled down and did a lot of good things. So, you know, I'm still optimistic about this football team regardless of what happens in this football game. But hopefully the second half will be better, and we'll get some offense going and make this interesting.
I think when you look at Nettleton's conference, especially with Batesville and Wynn in it, who are always at the top, and then there's another three or four teams that are in the playoff mix. And I think these guys will be at the top of that playoff mix. I mean, there may be a, you know, they could be a three and even possibly a two seed. I don't know how good Wynn's going to be this year. But, hey, this is a good quality football team we're playing. The Hounds are hanging around. And we're playing hard, great effort. We've had some mistakes, a few little mistakes. But we get those things ironed out. We've got to go take this football down right here and score if we're going to try to win this football game.
Yeah, I think so. And, again, I think we're going to have a good football team. We don't want to get let one game decide, you know, one half decide, you know, what this season's going to be like, and we're definitely not. Got a couple of really strong threats back deep for Newport. Carl with an excellent return on the first one. The second one kind of went over his head into the end zone. We'll see what happens here. Let's get some good field position. Kind of a low kick. Be fielded by Carl at the 15. Carl straight ahead, running hard. Carl Turner, well, just a step from breaking it again, Dave. That's two returns where he was just a step from breaking it. Excellent return of 21 yards to the 36.
Carl gets up a little slow, but he's just one of those guys that every time he touches the football, he's got a chance to go. And so here we go in the second half. We trail 14-0. That offense is back out there on the field. 53, Cordray Whitmore got the start, and I don't know that we mentioned him in the first half, but Nick Murphy is there at the left guard. And the center for the Hounds is Antonio Gomez. Sam Bowen, a guard. Caleb Statler at the other tackle, and Jordan Mabry is the tight end. He's number four. He was 21 last year. He's four this year.
Roddy with the pitch. Roddy outside to the speed. 35, 40. Darren Roddy, first down, I think, to the 45 or 46-yard line. First down right past the 45. Well, maybe just a tad short, but very close.
Play was designed to come our way, and it just they had it shut down, and Roddy just made a play going the other way, a little short of the first down. That's just good speed on his part and a good offensive play. The Hounds are near a first down, have some positives. Mentally in the ballgame at the top of your screen, wide.
Second and short. Motion again with Roddy. Inside first down, Newport. Gain up to the 47-yard line. Be first and 10 from the 47. That was Carl Turner on the carry.
And a whistle 10 seconds after the play. I'll find out. I'll ask Mark about that. Maybe it's a new rule. If it is, it's a silly rule.
It's a bad rule, I'll tell you that. A bizarre rule, to be honest with you. First and 10 from the 47.
Come on, Hounds.
Carl lines up behind Ben. Moore at the wing on this side. Inside to D.D. D.D. Moore, first down carry up to the 49-yard line. Gain of 5, second and 5.
I want to remind everybody the Greyhound boosters include KFC, located in the curve in Newport. All types of chicken, mashed potatoes, green beans, and all the fixings at KFC. Glass Plus, Highway 367 north of Newport for car, truck, windshields, or picture framing, general or specific framing, 523-3505. Judy and all the crew at Glass Plus.
There's Carl running hard. Carl up to the 45-yard line, just a couple of yards short of first down. Offense looking a little better coming out, David. You knew Coach Bradley would challenge that bunch, probably make some adjustments possibly, but they're playing better.
Well, you get as many first downs the first time you touch the football as you had in the first half, and the Hounds, it's what you call making adjustments at the half, and no doubt to Coach Hinesley and Coach Haynes and the rest of the staff.
They're a little different look with D.D. at this left wing and Carl lining up behind Ben. Quarterback sneak, that's a good call, and that's a first down. Now we fumbled the football, I think, and we got on it. Carl gets on it, but boy, that's a tough loss way back to the 49-yard line. It's going to bring up third down and about 7. Man, David, we had second and less than 1, and now, it's actually fourth down.
Wow.
That hurts. We had the first down and lose the football. Hounds appear to be going for it. Have to get to the 43, so it's 4th and 6.
Hounds are going to long count and punt.
Ben rolls, drops back. He's in deep trouble. And he'll be dropped for a loss, and the ball turns over on downs to Nettleton. And what started so promising really turned south quickly. First and 10, Nettleton at the Newport 45.
Well, you have, when you throw it on the ground like that, you fumble the football and you kick it around a little bit, especially with the late whistles, you know, it certainly cost the Hounds, and you have to decide right there, you know, 4th and 6 is, if you think you can get it, you go for it. If you don't think you can get it, you punt. Hounds thought we could get it, and we did not, so we give it up in Newport territory at the 45-yard line. We're going to ask the defense to make a hold here.
Motion this way. Hand off to Joe Frazier inside. Played well by the Hounds. So he gets off the bottom of that pile. I'm not sure, but David Colton Odell is going to be a good football player.
Yeah, he was in on the tackle. I didn't see who got there first. And we apologize to that young man. Defensively, Deshaun Anderson. Not a big kid. He's a couple of 100 pounds. He's number 57. Sam Bowen plays the defensive end. He's 210.
Well, played well by the Hounds. Sam Bowen there on the play. Great job by the Hound defense. Be 3rd and 11. O'Shea's around the play. D.D. Moore around the play.
Again, we wish our good friend, Coach Bill Keady, a speedy recovery. Baptist Hospital in Little Rock. Had some major heart surgery this Monday. Had a couple of bypasses and a new valve put in his heart.
3rd and 11.
Get well soon, my friend.
Come on, defense. Frazier. He brought down short of the first down. Nettleton probably 4-down territory. Be 3rd and 4th and 3 from 37. Have to get just inside the 35. They'll go for it or at least make us jump outside. More than likely, just go for it.
Yeah, first thing is that's what you look for. 7:46 to play in the third quarter. 14-0 in favor of Nettleton.
Boy, quick moving football game. Neither team throwing it.
Yeah, absolutely. Bumper to bumper, 610 Highway 367 North. Auto parts serviced at its best. Bill Malden, 523-3675.
Frazier, and he'll have the first down, and he's out more. Joe Frazier, 10-5, touchdown. 37-yard touchdown. Joe Frazier with his third TD of the game.
Yeah, he just got a good block, good trap block, and got a block on the corner, and good block on the safety, and it was just Katie barred the door there. Nettleton goes up by three scores, 20-0. At what looked like a promising drive. We talked about it at halftime. Boy, if we take his football down and drive it down there and score and make it a 14-6 or 14-8 game, you'd be in pretty good shape. Now we got to fight for our lives.
All down, kick up in the air, and it is no good. And with 7:14 to go in the third quarter, Nettleton 20, Newport 0.
Mark Manning, Shelter Insurance. He's located on Malcolm Avenue, 523-6514. Iberia Bank, Billy Keady. Will and Jake, Lindley Drive, 523-3611. Stephen Stacy Headley, the class of 1976. Churchman Building Center, Ace Hardware, 1500 Highway 367 North. For all your project and building needs, the Churchman Building Center. Larry Llewellyn, former Newport Greyhound. He's located down on Walnut Street. Does business accounting services, tax prep and planning, management consulting. Is it with Larry Llewellyn at 523-6764. Sam's Diner, you're talking about a plate lunch that is second to none. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, they got a plate lunch that's absolutely awesome. If you're looking for good food, try Sam's Diner on 2nd Street, the yellow building, for breakfast and lunch. Big Sam and the boys and girls at Sam's Diner.
Kickoff. Fielded at the 28. They returned up to the 33, a 5-yard return. Hounds with about as good a field position as they've had all night.
Other boosters include Mark and Beverly McGoy at McGoy Farms, Purdy's Flowers and Gifts at 815 Malcolm Avenue, John and Sheridan Chadwell, BNT Battery, Neil and Keith. You need a battery of any kind? Neil and Keith at BNT Battery. They're the battery guys at 2400. Highway 367 North. And Howard's Glass, new location, Highway 367 North. Windows, doors, glass, windshield, 523-3771, Howard's Glass Company.
Carl. Carl getting what he can up to the 36-yard line. Gain of 2, second down and 8. Carl just unable to get free. They're really stopping up the inside.
6:50 to play in the third quarter. We trail 20-0.
And Ben Collier, number 10, your Newport quarterback.
Subway, Carl. Subway, Subway, and more.
Carl out, O'Shea in.
Brings you the coaches show at the end of the broadcast. The Hounds will want a timeout. Randy, see, you kind of look at what the Hounds are doing here, and we got great potential. I mean, it's a different offense for us, and it's the first time in a real game. Of course, we had the scrimmage game against Valley View. This offense will get better. It will get better when we get in conference and we get to playing some guys who are more our competition. But we'll have guys in our conference just as good as this Nettleton bunch.
Yeah, there's two or three in our league certainly will be right there with them. So we're going to have to get better, no doubt about it, if we want to repeat as conference champions. Obviously, we want to extend that playoff streak to 29, but certainly would love to repeat as conference champions again.
You know, I was looking at the conference championship or the playoff streak, and I looked at some statistics. I thought I wrote them down, but I can't find them now. But I think Rising has been to the playoffs more times than the Hounds have. The Hounds are in second, but consecutively we are in first place. And one game ahead of Charleston, I think. We've been 28 in a row, Charleston 27. We've had 38 playoff appearances, and I think Rising has had 39.
Got Crite and Roddy and Dee Dee out left. O'Shea in the backfield. Little hitch out here to D.D. D.D. Moore played well by Nelton. Brought down about the 33-yard line. Loss of a couple on the play. Hounds trying to spread it out, trying to do something different. Just great pursuit by that Nettleton defense.
Well, you won't see it very often in Newport Greyhound football games where the other team has as much, if not more, speed. And this defensive speed from Nettleton is pretty darn good.
Yeah, they're fast. Third down and 11.
Zero guys going both ways.
Ben keeps it. Ben Collier, boy, he's hit hard. No gain on the play. Hounds will have to punt it. Fourth and 11 from the 34, or fourth and 10.
Punting team comes in, 5:28, clock moving third quarter. 20-0 in favor of the Raiders.
We don't have a punter. Carl's out. Dalton Menley will punt it. Hopefully he's lined up the right distance, because that can affect the deep snap. Good snap. Menley with a low kick, but an effective kick. Go out of bounds about the 26-yard line. Not a bad punt. About 41 yards on the punt by Dalton Menley. He may be our punter now. Because that was pretty good. Very effective.
Hound defense just got to find a way to get some stops right here. 4:51 remaining in the third quarter. What is it? I guess it's Green County Tech, Seven Hills, or Seven Hills, Green County Tech?
No, Green County Tech, Seven Hills.
Next two at Newport, correct?
Yeah, next three at Newport.
Next three.
We played six on the road last year, six at home this year, so.
You know, I had a lot of people complain last year about, well, we got a lot of road games, and I've not heard one people say, well, I'm excited about having six home games this year. Well, on the positive.
Let's go defense. I know some of these guys are getting awful tired. You just got to give it all you can. Frazier up to about the 32-yard line. Gained a five on the play. Second down and five.
And there was never a whistle. At least not a whistle on the play.
Nick Murphy in on that tackle. Also, Tyrell Fryer, sophomore, in on the play.
I want to mention about Subway and that Reuben sandwich with Kraut on it. Absolutely delicious, new at Subway. They sponsor the Coach Mark Hinesley show.
Great pursuit by Newport. Come on. Boy, great open field tackle there. Two flags on the play. The flag was apparently very obvious.
Sam Bowen will gingerly limp off the field.
Be holding or blocking the back against Nettleton, and that's a nice penalty to help the Hounds out.
Maybe on Sam, that's why
Sam's going to be okay, but off the field for a little while.
4:08 to play in the third quarter. We trail Nettleton 20-0.
Second down, long way. They've got to get to the 37. They're on the 16, so second and 21. Frazier, played well by the Hound defense. Nick Murphy and others, not much on the play. Brings up third down and probably about 21. Then they have to get to the 37. They're at the 16. 3:35 to go in the third quarter. Nettleton leads 20-0.
O'Shea Pruitt, 24, and four Jordan Mabry, the linebackers. Jordan Neal in the secondary.
Third and 22. Frazier, wide left. Good pursuit by the Hounds, and he'll be brought down. Short gain of about two. Brings up fourth down and 20. Again, the Hound defense, David, to me, doing a lot of good things tonight.
Sure.
A couple of breakdowns, but overall, I'm pretty pleased with the defensive effort. Still waiting for that offense to come around. Nelton will punt. Colton Odell did a great job of fielding the previous punt.
He's going to be a dandy.
He's going to be a player. I'm telling you, it's, you know, of somebody that didn't know a lot about. Very excited about that young man. I think I've heard his grandmother talk a little bit about him before. And
I have, yes.
Yes, so.
I'm excited that he was back in Newport.
Yeah, getting to see some of that ability, that talent. Punter takes forever to kick it because he's got time. Colton just stays away. A short kick and a bounce for Newport. And Hounds have it in Nettleton territory for the second time tonight, I guess, at the 46. First and 10, Newport. Let's go score. 2:09 to go in the third quarter. We trail 20 to nothing.
Yeah, I think it's imperative, Randy, that you get some positive momentum going here offensively. Got to move the football, move the chains.
Just got to get some confidence, you know. I think we get that confidence that this offense is going to work, going to move the football, going to score. Carl back in the game after being out for a couple of plays earlier. He'll line up on this left wing. Roddy on the right wing. O'Shea Pruitt in the backfield behind Ben Collier. Carl in motion. Drop snap. Well, Ben just a step from breaking it with his speed. He gets about three up to the 43-yard line, 42 we'll call it.
And no whistle again. I don't understand it.
I have no idea. I mean, that's – It's very bizarre, in my opinion. You have to have a whistle. How do you know when to stop? How do you know when there's a personal foul? How do you know anything?
I don't know how they make that work.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, the kid that's running the ball knows when he's down. But generally, other than the guy tackling him, nobody else knows.
Second and six. Inside handoff. Well, again, this Nettleton defense just playing so well.
And we're close. We're a half a step away.
Yeah, I know. There's about three or four plays. We've been a half a step from just breaking a big one. And give those guys the credit. Four down territory, obviously third down and four for Newport at the 39. Call it third down and three, closer.
1:07 to play third quarter. We trail 20-0.
Two running backs behind. There goes Carl spinning, and he brought down, I think, just short of a first down. They did blow the whistle there. Going to be about a yard short, fourth down for Newport. Obviously, we'll go for it. Let's get a first down, guys. 40 seconds to go here in the third quarter. We trail 20-0, trying to get something going offensively. Very close to the first down. Hounds with some success on the first drive of this half on the quarterback sneak before the fumble, but we actually moved it. I don't really know what that was about. The Hound offense goes over to the sideline, but there's don't know of any timeout. Certainly plenty of time left in the quarter. Fourth down and one.
Got to convert here.
Got to convert. O'Shea Pruitt to the left of Ben. DD and Darren the wings. It's quarterback sneak. We'll see the forward progress, and they're not going to give him anything. They're going to give him a loss on the play, and the ball turns over to Nettleton.
On the far side over there has got it marked first down. Yeah, absolutely. He had it marked first. He was a yard further up than the referee on this side. He had it marked all the way first down.
Richie Mathis trying to get a timeout.
Well, the Nettleton defense thought that they had stopped, and according to the official right here, as they looked at it, The official on this side was at the 37-yard line, and the official on the other side had it marked between the 36 and the 35. And they blew a whistle.
It wasn't Coach Mathis. There's a couple, three of them looked like Coach Mathis from behind. Actually, another quarterback ran, Coach Kent ran up there and called the timeout. But thankfully, the good spot from the official on the far side got the forward progress. I certainly thought he was further than this guy indicated, but I wasn't sure if he quite got the first down. But luckily, we got the spot, got a first down. Let's go score, guys.
We need a touchdown now.
D.D. Moore, number one, cuts outside with some speed. That's a nice gain for Newport. D.D. very, very quick.
And just keep plugging right here. Keep after it. Keep moving the football.
Let's go. Let's get some confidence. We know we're going to have a good offense at some point. Second down and four for Newport. This should be the last play of the third quarter. If we run it, we may not get it off. We do. Ben keeps it inside. No gain up to the near the 30-yard line. That's the end of the third quarter with your score. Nettleton 20 and Newport 0.
Randy, one of the things I've noticed, we're just getting beat at the point of attack and on both sides of the ball. Yeah. And a lot of that has to do with, I mean, these guys and their strength and their agility and their quickness, especially defensively. They're real good defensively. And we saw a Valley View football team a couple of weeks ago and talked about in that conference. They're in the same conference as this one. And Valley View's one of those teams that'll be fighting for a playoff berth, but I don't think nearly as good as this bunch is right
now. No, I don't think so. Not right now for sure.
Ben Black's Used Cars, if you want to sell your car, he likes to buy older model cars and trucks. So if you've got an older model vehicle that you're thinking about selling, you don't need it anymore, or you just want to get a good price for it and you really don't want to trade it in, give old Ben a chance to buy that car. Give him a call at 512-8429. See how many $100 bills he can offer you for it. He doesn't buy the $6,000, $7,000, $8,000 stuff, but he does buy the $1,000, $2,000 stuff. Give him a call if you think you've got one of those. But don't call him if you've got a $1,200 one and you want $4,500 more.
Third down, Newport. This will be the first play of the fourth quarter. Third down and a long five. O'Shea. Ben's in trouble. And boy, just no chance for Ben. A great call, but just couldn't get the play off because of the pressure from Nettleton.
Hounds will go here. 11:54 remaining in the football game. 20-0 in favor of the Raiders.
Well, but David, I've been thinking if you get a screen off, but you can't even get it off with this pressure. Might be a good play, and it's about what we had there, just too much pressure. Fourth down and six for Newport. Got to get almost to the 25.
Yeah, they got 11 guys in the box.
And they go off sides, and that would make it fourth and short. Fourth down and less than one. Well, they give us first down, don't they? And the referee is indicating first down. I thought it was short.
He's still calling first down, and no.
Not now, but he kept on pointing one finger and pointing down like a first down. Come on, guys. No chance. No chance for Carl. Ball turns over to Nettleton. They'll take it at their 38-yard line. It looks like 11:47 to go in this football game. Nettleton leads 20-0.
I think with this bunch, I just think you stay the course, you keep doing the things that you're working on, and you get better. Make great improvements from game one to game two.
First and 10 from the 34. Again, Kobe Pratt, the quarterback, Joe Frazier, running back behind him. Frazier, well, good speed and hits that hole hard, and he'll take the pile forward for a gain of 8 up to the 42-yard line, second and 2 for Nettleton.
And we talk about Nettleton having never beaten the Greyhounds, and we probably won't play anytime soon after this with us dropping to AAA. And when you drop to AAA, your 5A schools really don't want to play you, but they don't have anything to gain by playing you. I mean, if they beat you, they're supposed to beat you. And if they lose to you, they go, why did you lose to somebody that's in AAA? Come on, Hounds.
Inside, number 2 on the carry. Played pretty well by the Hound defense. 72, Darrell Hardman, and he's going to be a heck of a football player. He's just a sophomore, 6'3", 280. Very capable of becoming a dominant football player.
Randy, if you love the game and you want to work at the game, he's one of those kids that's got all the talent in the world.
Third down and 1. Clock running, 10.5 minutes to go in the football game.
Trailing 20-0 are the Hounds.
Straight ahead, Frazier. Darrell Hardman. Good defensive play. They'll get the first down, but Darrell with a good defensive play there on the tackle. First and 10, Nettleton at their own 48-yard line. They will milk the clock all they can right now. Try to string first downs.
Have I mentioned that fried chicken out there at Newport Shell?
I think you said it's pretty good. Maybe
real
the
good.
Best ever.
I went in there today, and I said, give me a couple of wings. I said, oh, you don't have any wings. You don't have any Brett Boyd. And they were just a swamp of people. I said, if you got any left, they had some thighs. Boy, they were great. Got me some thighs. Fried chicken. It's pretty good.
Fumble the football, and Crite gets back on it, and they do blow a whistle. Be brought back to the 39-yard line. Get lost by about 9 on the play. Brings up a long yardage situation.
Robert Turner, McLean Street, Newport. We talked about them moving out to the new building. Robert and his dad, Mike, are going to share an office on Stegall Road. Medical Park Orthopedic and Sports Medicine Clinic. They take care of athletes. Dylan Carpenter, Jeff Angel, Dr. J.D. Allen. Your phone number is 793-2371.
Second and 19. Inside to Frazier. Boy, played well by that Hound defense. 57, Deshaun Anderson. Got a lot of good things out of this Newport defense, and I feel pretty good about this bunch.
Well, I like our team. I think we're okay. It's the first year in many years that we haven't been in the spread and throwing the football, and we're breaking in a new quarterback and got some young guys that are playing. But we've got talent. We got some talent in junior high. We got some kids coming. We dropped out of AAA. We're going to be a force.
Got a bunch of Pee Wee kids. That's great. Hopefully we can keep those guys interested. Frazier, again, a good job by that Newport defense. That'll bring up a fourth down. Punting situation.
Yeah, pretty good stick there by Jordan Neal. May qualify as a Brand Body Shop Collision of the Week.
Still a chance for this Newport offense to get some confidence, make something good happen here. Again, Odell, deep for Newport. Colton Odell, 5'9", 175. Again, only a sophomore.
Just looks the part, doesn't he?
Yeah. Looks like a player. Don't know him, but he looks, just looking at him, I think he's got that football mentality, it looks like to me, just looking at him. Good pressure on the kicker. Short kick and takes a Newport bounce. We fielded it, looks like the 41-yard line. They'll mark it at the 42 of Newport. Be first and 10, Newport against 7:48 to go in this football game. We trail 20-0.
Subway Coaches Show, Mark Hansley. Subway in the Walmart Supercenter, 523-2309. Brand Body Shop looking for a collision of the week. And Cable15TV.com for all your sports. Folks, if you've never been to Cable15TV.com, just Google it and go to there. Just see what we do there. We embed all our programs that we do and got some specials that we've done down through the years. You can watch 25 Years of Greyhound Greatness, or you can watch Our Town 2010, which is a great video.
Inside handoff up to the 40-yard line. Gained about one, maybe two on the play. Second down, Newport. That was O'Shea Pruitt on the carry. Darrell Hardman on that offensive line right now. Got Sam Bowen, Statler out there. Antonio Gomez at the center. And Hardman at the left tackle. Screen across the middle, and it's dropped. They had a little something going on right there, but pass will be incomplete, bring up third down for Newport. Left guard is Nick Murphy, 61.
Twenty to nothing, the Hounds trail Newport with the ball. We need something good to happen here on third and long.
Dalton Mendley in the game lines up at the tight end on the right side. Three receivers left. Ben rolls. Throws it deep, and he's got incomplete. Boy, it's close to completion out there. Jay Kreit just a little bit overthrown. Fourth down, Hounds like to punt the football. So we'll see Mendley kick it again after, I think, a 41-yard punt on his previous attempt. Yeah, he stays in the game, and he will line up to punt it. Line of scrimmage, the 40-yard line, 6:56 to go in the game when we trail 20-0. O'Shea Pruitt is the up man. Good snap by Zach. Punt fielded at the 30. Cuts it back this way. Good job. Good tackle from behind there, and that was number six on the play. It's Jordan Neal.
You know, he came down, and he got juked, and he missed the tackle. And then he came right back, and he got the tackle. And I like that effort. Yeah. I love that effort. That's a great effort by Newport Greyhound.
Like we may have a cramp out there. It's number eight, Tyler Calamese. No, excuse me, number eight for Nelton's Dre Nesby. I assume that's probably a cramp. Yep. Not many for a hot night like this. I remember years where there'd be people cramping up all over the field on a hot night like this on the first game.
You know, I do too, Randy. I don't know that maybe the summer workouts probably helped that. The 7-on-7 when these kids are actually working in the heat more so than they did 10, 15 years ago. But, cramps early in the year have always been a problem. I mean, I remember back in many, many years ago, when I played back in the 70s where – you've got cramps. You just got them.
Yeah. Pretty common.
I want to mention Bryson Elston. We just saw Bryson, and he came up with an idea. Bryson's Lawn Care Service going to give a player of the game tonight after the game to both Newport and Nettleton. He has some connections here to the Nettleton School and obviously a great football player for the Greyhounds. And so they're going to announce that after the game. We'll have to get out of here very quickly. So we may not be able to bring that to you. We hope to bring Coach Hansley, and you look at logistic problems sometime about how far away they are and how long it takes to him to get here.
Frazier, I think, on the carry. Give him three up to the 38-yard line. Tyler Linville around the play. Also Caleb Statler.
And Dan, who's listening to us upstairs, here's what we'll do at the end of the game. We'll close it out. I'll come help you. We'll bring the camera down here. We'll set it up just in case Coach Hansley is able to join us.
Second down and seven. 6:10 and counting in this football game. inside. But I just like some things this bunch is doing defensively. We're really battling, playing hard there. And
Tyler Lemple's had two or three big hits.
He's kind of my front runner for the Brand Body Shop Collision.
I totally agree.
64, Colby McCoy out there playing well. Deshaun Anderson back in the game.
I like our football team. I do too. I
think offensively we're going to be pretty good. We played a heck of a football team tonight. Especially up front. Another good play. Just look at that penetration.
That's
57, Deshaun Anderson. Big loss on the play. Third down and 11. Like that fourth down, they hadn't moved the marker yet, but it's fourth and 11.
5:15, clock moving.
Would really just love to see us get one score here, make something good happen offensively.
Hey, I'll let you know who I got for the play of the game. For Newport, it's number 72, Loretta Hardeman. And then for Middleton, it's Joe Frazier.
Got you covered. There's Big Bryson right there. We just talked about him. He's going to give the players the game. He's already told us who he's going to award those to. Bryson Elston at Elston's Lawn Care Service. You see the punt being dead there near the 30-yard line. I mean, just a pretty good twist on, you know, wanting to give back.
Yeah.
Wanting to give back. Bryson Elston, boy, a great Greyhound. And
he was a good football player.
Yeah, great young man, too.
First
for Newport,
ten.
Excuse me, I was going to say, Randy, he's going to give an award to Darrell Hardeman, who's the big kid, the big sophomore kid. He's for the Greyhounds, and Joe Frazier for Nettleton. He's not going to do that every week. He just wants to do it for the Newport-Nettleton game, which I think is neat. I think it's real, real neat. ASU Newport, you can learn the skills for a career that's in demand, and less than a year, you could be the one in demand. Don't wait. Apply for any of the fine programs that they have, a path of success with programs like diesel technology and renewable energy, high voltage lineman technology, surgical technology, commercial truck driving, practical nursing, and more. Stay close to home and get hands-on training at affordable prices, plus financial aid is available for those who qualify at ASU Newport. It is indeed a great place to start.
4:34 to go in this football game. There's a timeout on the field. Wasn't sure who called that, but 4:34 to go in the game. It'll be first down Newport at their own 30. Hounds trail 20-0. Again, next week, 5A Murderers Row continues. We will play Greene County Tech at Newport. The week after that, what I think is probably a heck of a football team, Sylvan Hills Bears. And they've got about 80 kids down there, and they really got that thing going. So, for me, a couple of tough 5A schools the next couple of weeks. Hopefully that'll make us better as we prepare for the conference season.
Yeah, and then Helena comes to town.
Yeah. Doesn't get any easier, does it?
Whew. Is it Lone Oak the next week? I can't even remember that far ahead.
Yeah, probably. First and 10 from the 30.
Let's just score right here.
And we've got a timeout Newport. Apparently some confusion or something, because we had to call a timeout immediately after the previous timeout.
You know, we talked about Coach Harrod earlier, and Ken Black, who coaches in junior high, talked about another Newport Greyhound that's come home to be a part of this great tradition of Newport Grey Pup Greyhound football, and he actually signals in the plays from the sideline for Coach Bradley. So you've got Coach Black, you've got Coach Haynes, you've got Coach Reynolds. All Newport Greyhound. And all these guys give their heart and soul to this program.
Absolutely.
All of those coaches do. I like our team.
I do too. Ben straight back, throws it deep. What just a great attempt out there. We're going to have an interference call, so. That's D.D. Moore, I think. The interference against Nettleton. Give the Hounds a first down. Well, D.D. battling all the way. Thought he was going to end up making a tremendous catch. He's a kid that can run. Ball will be spotted up at the 45-yard line. I thought it was.
Well, he's going to take it back to the 30, and then he's going to mark it off back here to the 45,
I think. Where he started, that's where he'll put it. First and 10 from the 45-yard line.
Hounds get a first down there. That's one of those rules that I don't like in high school, that it's – I think it ought to be a spot foul. And what I mean by a spot foul, as opposed to coming back to the line of scrimmage mark off 15 yards, it should be placed where the interference occurred.
Yeah. Carl running hard up to the 49-yard line. Gain of 4 on the play. Second down and 6. Again, Statler, Bowen, Gomez, Hardiman. Nick Murphy, I think, at left guard for the offensive line for Newport. Jay Kreit goes wide left. Menley out to the right along with Roddy. Carl Turner lines up to the right of Ben Collier. Boy, Carl giving it all he's got. You know, they've been keying on that young man tonight. It'd be third down and 3 from the 48-yard line.
.334 remaining in the game. Still 20-0 in favor of Nettleton. I'd like to end this thing on a positive note here. Break a long one.
Carl lines up behind Ben. Inside. There goes Carl. Inside the 30 to the 25-yard line. That's a little spark. First down, Newport.
Yeah, let's finish this thing off with a touchdown right here. 3:09 to play in the football game, 20-0. White River Area Agency on Aging has moved to 1200 Highway 367 North, just right around the corner from where they were. A little north there on the North Highway. They're on the, obviously, the east side. They're next door to Glass Plus, which is formerly Reba's Uniforms.
First and 10, Newport at the 26. Roddy with the toss. Fumbles the football and Nettleton gets it. Boy, I thought we were going to have a positive drive there, and ball turns over to Nettleton. 2:43 to go in the football game. They will try to run the clock out, leading 20-0. Been a very fast-moving football game, which included about a 25 to 28-minute halftime. We're still going to be over around 9:15, it looks like. Very few passes tonight by either team.
Nettleton leads here in the football game, and going to try to close it out right here.
Hand off to number 3, and looks like Colton Odell holding on, making the tackle.
And a big hit by Darrell Hardiman again. I tell you what, I like that kid too.
There's no doubt that, again, he can be dominant. He's been dominant at some other levels he's played at, and Pee-wee in junior high, and certainly that can happen in senior high as well. If he puts his mind to it, he can be an incredible football player. Don't use the term dominant very much, but he can be that kind of guy.
Yes, he could.
Second down and 5. Hand off to number 3.
There he is again.
Should have enough for a first down, I think. That's number 3 on the carry for Nettleton. It's Datavian Turner, another sophomore playing.
What college coaches look for in a big guy like that is a play just like he did. Not only can you whip somebody at the line of scrimmage, but can you run down the line of scrimmage and run somebody down? And that's what he just did.
Yeah.
Joe Frazier is the player of the game for Nettleton. Bryson Elston's lawn care, and Darrell Hardiman, player of the game for the Greyhounds. And a timeout on the field with 2:01 to play. Randy, I really think some positives here tonight. Anytime you lose, you lost, but it's a game. It's a game played by young men in preparation, and I think the Hounds were prepared. I think Nettleton's a better football team than us.
That's all you can say, yeah.
And that doesn't mean that they've worked harder than us. I think they've got a few more athletes than what we had. Well, we had a big crowd here tonight. Well, we need a big crowd
at home
next week.
Yeah. Green County Tech, once again, next Friday night, 7 o'clock, legendary Greyhound Field. Junior high team will be on the road next week, but those guys will be back in Newport on the 17th against Mountain Home, 7 o'clock. It's an exciting team to watch. Come and watch those guys play on the 17th. Put that on your calendar right now. And again, three straight home games for the Hounds. Green County Tech, Sylvan Hills, West Helena. Let's go, guys. 2:01 to go in the game. The clock is running, 1:57 and counting.
Check out NewportARCity.org. Proud past, bright future, Newport NEDC. Kirtner Lumber Company at the Newport Air Base. And Lindley Health and Rehab Center at 326 Lindley Lane. Look at some of their videos on cable15tv.com or on my Facebook page.
Three again. Great pursuit by the Hounds. That's number 16 on the play. Tydrell Fryer again. We knew that sophomore could play. He was the quarterback in junior high. 1:25 to go in this football game. A couple, three more plays from Nettleton.
Kobe McCoy in, playing a little defense for the Hounds. I just think from an athletic standpoint, I think we're talented.
Yeah.
Got a lot of young guys, got a lot of inexperienced guys.
They'll grow up.
You got Ben Carrier, who's had one game under his belt as quarterback. He will get better, much better.
Busted play right there, and they'll lose three on the play. Have to run one more play. Boy, Dave, there's just nothing like high school football on a Friday night. I'm telling you what, it's exciting. I mean, it hadn't been the greatest of games for Newport, but it's still just great to be here and watch these guys play.
Well, I've been announcing for 34 years, and I cannot imagine not being able to come on a Friday night, not only to watch a football game, but to announce a Newport Grand football game. I can't imagine not doing
that. You're going to get me emotional now, because I tell you what, the Friday after last year's last game, that next Friday night, I remember Paul and I went out to eat and coming home, that was on my mind.
Is that right?
I might not do that again.
Is that right?
And that was a tough night for me,
tough,
to be honest
with
you.
It's emotional? Yeah.
Just getting to know these kids, anybody that's never been involved, getting to know these kids is just an incredible experience. That's going to do it. 5 seconds to go. The clock's going to run out. The Newport Greyhounds will lose their opener 20-0, but Nettleton, but a lot of positive signs, David, and I'm ready for next week.
Well, no doubt that the Hounds will get better. They'll go back to the drawing board. Nothing to hang your head about. It was just a night in which the Hounds met their match in Nettleton. Nettleton beats the Newport Greyhounds 20-0. We're going to take a break. Hopefully Coach Hansley will be back. We'll try to get all the equipment set up. Hounds lose 20-0. Coach Hansley is next. We want to remind everybody that the Brand Body Shop Collision of the Week goes to Tyler Limble and, of course, the Mark Hansley Show, brought to you by Subway in the new Walmart Supercenter. Coach, appreciate you coming up graciously. 20-0, the Hounds lose, and a lot of things to work on, and we knew that coming in it was a good quality football team, but a lot of positives to take away from what happened tonight.
Well, and, you know, with a game like that, I found a free safety tonight. You know, Colton Odell, I put him in after Ben was just gassed early. I threw Colton in, and the kid just played his guts out. And I couldn't expect anything more from a sophomore,
yeah,
by the way, David.
Yeah.
So, some props to Colton Odell. That kid played his heart out. I used a lot of people tonight defensively, and I'm talking on the defensive side of it. I used a lot of people defensively. You used Tyler Linville. I repped him in at nose, in and out. I used Antonio
Gomez. And he played
Gomez. Played well. Antonio Gomez. Caleb Stadler and Darrell Hardman had a good little rotation going.
Sure.
And then Darrell, I saw when we were coming off the field, got player of the game for Newport.
Absolutely, yeah.
So,
When
I watched the tape, he's obviously done some good things out there.
Yes, sir.
Nick Murphy and Sam Bowen, they barely come off the field tonight. I mean, they played their guts out. And, that's the thing we knew going into this, is we had a lot of kids going both ways.
Sure.
And we knew that we were going to have to be in conditioning. We knew that we were going to have a somewhat of a rotation in order to keep both, sides of the ball healthy enough to move the ball and to stop them moving it.
Well, we threw it on the ground a couple of times offensively that really hurt us when we looked like we were going to, as Randy Klopecha said here, we're going to start ginning right here, and threw it on the ground a couple of times. Those are things that can be corrected. Ben, first time he's played quarterback in a real right. football game. I mean, we've had a quarterback 3 years in a row, but I thought overall I liked our effort. I like our team. I think we're athletic enough. But
right.
You talk about the goose egg. Sometimes you have a goose egg thrown at you, but a zero is a zero.
Yeah, and you know, it always stings. There's no zero that doesn't
sure.
sting unless you're on the other end of it, you know, defensively.
Right.
But, you know, and you're right. You know, Ben getting thrown into a new position, you know, and a scrimmage is a scrimmage. I hate to say that, but it
sure.
is a scrimmage. And this was live action out there, and he really got, you know, thrown in the fire tonight, and it showed at times. And the number one thing that I talked about this week is the things that we can help are two guys going in motion. We did that tonight.
Right.
Putting the ball on the ground.
Absolutely.
You know, those are things that we can change. That's the little things. And that's what I talked about downstairs a while ago was the little things. You know, penalties like that, the two guys going in motion, they know they're supposed to communicate that.
Sure.
That's stuff that we can change, and we will change it. The putting on the ground, we talk about that till we're blue in the face. We've got to change that. You've got to hold on to the rock if we're gonna keep going forward with it. So that's things that we can change. Defensively, it was tackling. You know, we talked about it all week is tackling. And, you know, we always talk about high zone and low zone. You know, high zone's on the chest, low zone's in the legs.
Sure.
Kid like Jumping Joe Frazier, you've got to get in his legs. I mean, the kid runs the ball hard.
Yes, sir, he does.
And you know, if you try to high zone him, you're going to do exactly what we saw a little bit tonight of bouncing off of him. We've got to attack that guy in his thighs. And if we do that, and that's what I kept telling him at halftime, do it my way now. You try it your way. You try to high zone him. You try to get in his chest. Now do it my way, get in his thighs. So, you know, it's little things. And that's what I told the kids. It's the effort was there.
Absolutely.
We've got athletic ability. We've got speed. The pieces of the puzzle are there. It's the little things we got to put together and go forward.
Well, there's no doubt about it. We talked about that on our broadcast that we like our team. We've got athletes. We made a few mistakes, but you know, you go from game one to game two, and that's when you ought to be able to correct those things. And you get thrown into the fire like a lot of these kids tonight. A lot of sophomores playing a lot of action. We got a lot of young guys.
And, you know, I'm not a guy for making excuses, but we did. We have a lot of kids. You know, I thought Tyrell Fryer did an excellent job. He's starting to see the game in a more slowed down pace now. He's doing an excellent job for us. Jordan Mabry, who was a defensive end last year, now is a linebacker for us, doing a great job.
Absolutely.
I mean, I can't complain about that kid. You got O'Shea Pruitt, who's a sophomore. So I think we are building for the future. We really are. I mean, I do. You're right. I do like our team. I really do, because I think we're doing things the right way. It's just the little things that we've got to work on every week. And it's like I told the kids all along. The good football team in my mind is the team that constantly builds and gets better.
Sure.
That's a good football team to me.
Sure.
Because you're seeing things week to week and you're changing what you're doing. You're getting better at what you're doing. So, you know, that's what I'm wanting out of this team is just do little things right and keep building.
Well, we're going to do that, and the Hounds, they're going to give us 9 more chances through the regular season to see what happens at the end of the year.
So
we
should see different Hounds every week.
Absolutely. And I think we'll get better, Coach.
We will. We will continue to get better, and that's my job. And I'm gonna do my job.
Mark Hinesley, my friend, head football coach, athletic director of the Newport Greyhounds. I like the direction we're going. We will get better. Thanks for watching.
Go Hounds.